want to see the Wildcats do a little bit better. You were just under 9 minutes. I think they need to continue to run their offense a little better. As Dan Ogier and Jordan James are both in the game for the Wildcats. Color lineup for Wayne State as Luke Terhart takes the inbound pass. No good on the three-pointer. And they're going to say it was out of bounds off of the line pass. So Wayne State's going to, or excuse me, Preston's going to take over as Wayne State wants to put the pressure.
Yeah, Wayne State coming out more full court press now. Terhart guarding Tyson. Getting the ball back to Eden Anderson. Eden Anderson sets back into this game. Top of the key. Handing it off. Going up. Strong in Davis. And good for Gabe Davis. Another 2 points. Looking added on to his total. As the Huskies pull back to them three. It will be Jordan Jansen giving it to Ben Dellinger. Dellinger has top of the key giving it to Jackson. Jackson pulling up just inside the three-point line. No good rebound to by Luka. Luka taking the ball before giving it to Davis. Davis back down to Luka. Setting up the offense is Gee Anderson. Down to Luka. Luka down to Davis. Davis goes up strong. That is nice. And good ball to Davis. As the Wildcats bring ball up court across the timeline. Here's Terhart. Terhart looking to come off screen by Jordan Jansen. Giving it to Fair Reed. Have not attempted a shot yet tonight. And that will be picked off by Luka. Luka taking the ball on fast break. Kicking it out to the corner. Back now to the top of the key. And that will be number 22. Jason Mitchell for Fair Reed. And there will be a timeout. We will take a short break. We will be right back for more Wildcat basketball. As the Wayne State Wildcats take on the St. Cloud State Huskies. Huskies have a 2-point advantage right now, up 20-22-21 on the Wildcats. As the Wildcats inbound basketball, it will be Vance Jansen back in for the Wildcats up at the top of the key. Slowing things down a bit. I don't think Coach Kinski was too happy with the high-paced offense from last possession, so making sure things get slowed down a bit. As Vance Jansen pulls up for three, and that is good. Nice shot by Vance Jansen. Down to Davis. Davis goes up strong now. Davis has the Wildcats to pull back.
Davis has 13 points on the evening. Wayne State needs to figure out what to do.
Ferry gives it to Vance Jansen. Jansen backs things out. Gives it down low to Jordan Jansen. Back out to Ferry. Ferry pump fake goes up 10 footer. It's good. For his first 2 points in basketball.
Took one dribble, got to about that 10-foot line, and
jeez, another 10-footer, good. Jordan Davis, his 15th point of the ball game. He is on an absolute tear, and the Wildcats cannot seem to stop him. As Jax takes the ball, left wing, gets it to Jordan Dance, back to Dance Dance, back to Jax. Jax driving left side, reverse layup is no good. A lot of contact, but no call as Aluka gets the rebound, driving. Basically, 1-on-4, and he scores. Nice spin move by Aluka to give the Huskies a 3-point lead with just over 5 minutes remaining in this first half.
basketball team. Having a lot of success this year in basketball, and really just looking to get an all-important NSIC win here to see why it's down to
the it will be Husky basketball as they break full court press. Oh, move to half ball. Right wing. Got the key. Is coming off of the screen, giving it back to Onwuka. Onwuka looking for spin. No call by the official. Back out to Onwuka. Onwuka 4-3. No good. A ball deflected around a bit, but eventually lands in the hands of a Husky. As that will be Tyson 4-3. As the Husky will continue to play in the hole. Jansen top key, nice, but by Vance Jansen. Takes things out nice and slow. Vance Jansen in the corner to Demi Jax. Jax driving left side. And there will be no shot, but there will be a foul on the floor. So it will maintain Wildcats basketball with 3:24 left in this first half. Jansen didn't know if they cleared the lead. So that's pretty good. You'd like to see him make clear that one. Isn't going to affect the game. Joseph on the left wing. Top key driving on the right side. Going up high. Get into double digits on the night and tie things up for the Wildcats. Tavius Jackson is getting ready to check in as the free throw is missed. Rebound by Huskies. Huskies have the ball, get it across half court. Taking the ball up is Davis. Handing it off to number 22 Kishon. Down low. Nice little move by Davis for Davis. Only the 17th point of the night. At the high elbow is Jordan Jansen. Hands it off to Trevin Joseph. Hands it off to Jax. Jax down low. Jordan Jansen. Right up, just a
this time.
He's absolutely gasping for air out there. Every possession, he's working his tail off. That Ferrini three, he was looking to get position to maybe get a tip in or potentially get an offensive rebound as the first free throw. He's good.
That's because the defense is good.
Jordy Dixon comes out. Excuse me, that was his first foul of the ball. It's not even close to being a foul of the ball. And checking in at his place, he's been down here. A very solid, tall player for the Wildcats. Fresh legs, 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Nice set of free throws by Luka as number 40, Sean Smith, checks in for the Huskies.
Huskies looking to put some pressure on here for the Wildcats. At least spinning around. Luka may get a steal here. Today's free throw.
Jansen taking things slow. 20, approximately 9 seconds separating shot clock and the game clock. Jax hands off Ferrini. Ferrini, nice cut by Vance Jansen. Nice cut.
I'm not sure he was necessarily ready for it. That's a very good free throw shooter. And Vance Jansen makes his free throw.
Second in is Altavius Jackson for the Wildcats, a very good hustle player for Wayne State as Ethan Anderson gets the ball across that board, excuse me, taking it to the top of 10 seconds remaining, no shot clock. Wow, as Gabe Davis goes up and puts it on. And that will end the same starting five. It will be Brindley Tyson, Adam Anderson, Gabe Davis, Sean Smith, and Diamond on Luka. There's a little bit of confusion on the court as the refs are talking to both the coaches.
Officials, not exactly sure what they're going to say, but they're going to say the possession arrow was wrong. It'll start on defense, still have an opportunity to extend this lead here earlier on in the second half.
Coach Minsky obviously not too thrilled about that, but life goes on as the Huskies have the basketball time. Is Davis. Davis backing out, excuse me. Tries a lob pass down low, but it will be kicked out of bounds. Sean Smith could not finish that lob. It will be locked at that basketball.
Coach Minsky probably will be out of start with the ball, but in the end, they run off 14 seconds and he'll have the next jump ball. So, Coach Minsky might be too upset with that. His defense will look clutched in on the first position of the second half.
Jax has the ball, gives it to Ferrini. Ferrini swings it to Jordan Jackson. Gives it back to Jackson for him. Jax drives. Nice pass down. Look, he's holding. He puts it up. He's going to walk out with 2-4. That will be a 15-footer for the Huskies as Gabe Davis drives and his foul on the layup. So we will head to line shoot two as that is the first foul for the Wildcats in the second half.
Second of the game. Wayne State did a real nice job in the first half of that play. The Huskies put up the shot, got an air ball. Wayne State was looking like they were just going to let the ball run out of bounds. The Huskies disagreed with that, though. The Huskies went, chased that ball down, got it inside, and Davis now adds to an already impressive night as he looks to go off for potentially a 30-point game. That has 22. You guys have 23 points.
Yeah, obviously, Jeremy Joseph not wanting to pick up a quick third foul, so we might want to start being a little bit careful here until a little bit of time winds down as the Wildcats get it across the timeline. And Vance Jansen moves back down inside of the offense. Jansen can't beat it to Ferrini on the left wing. And now to Jax, Jax back to Jordan Jansen, hands it off to Joseph. Joseph gets back to Ferrini. Ferrini on the right wing back to Joseph. Joseph on top of the two step back three, and that is off for a rim. No good. Rebounded by Smith. Smith is out on the run on the left wing. Gives it to number 20, Davis. Davis drops back. Gives it to Anderson. Johnson looks down low to him. But look, that was way off by Onwuka. As Wildcats have the ball down low, is Jordan Jansen goes up, and that is no good. Partially tipped by Onwuka. Nice job by him to get back on defense for a block shot.
Jordan Jansen also chasing the rest of the back. Jordan did a nice job. He's showing a little bit of defense there.
And that ball will be tipped outbounds by the Wildcats. It will remain busted down the ball as in comes number 22, Jace Kitchen, in favor of Diamond Onwuka. Passing in. Down low is Davis, and he is fouled going up, so he will go to the line yet again for two more free throws.
We still have almost empty minutes left. He gave the ball game. Coach is going to the bench. He pulls off Octavius Jackson, says, Trenton Justice is going to take a little bit of a seat here as Davis' first free throw is good. He must be that two or six of six from here. Davis is now 3 of 3 from the free throw line.
Jackson, obviously very talented, one of the most athletic kids on the Wayne State Wildcat roster, but not quite as efficient of a scorer as Wilson. So it will be interesting to see how the Wildcats adapt that as the Huskies bring on their full court press. Jackson, the ball stolen by Smith. Smith passes it back to Smith for the dunk, but there is a foul on the floor first. So it will be the third foul. The 13th foul, excuse me, on the Wildcats.
Jordan picks up his second foul of the game, so a little bit of concern here for the Wildcats, not able to do what they did defensively.
Kitchen for three, and that is good to give the Huskies a 3-point lead with 17:30 remaining in the second half as Vance Jansen takes the ball to court. Guarded heavily by Heath Anderson. Hands off to Barry. Barry top of the key. He's back to Dax. Dax down low to Jordan Jansen. Out to Barry. Out to Altavia Jackson. Back to Barry. Barry down low to Jordan Jansen. Nice spin move. And there will be a foul on the floor. That foul is on number 20, Gabe Davis. That will be his second foul on the floor. We'll take care of the second half.
So far on the staff, we're going to figure out a way to get the ball in the bucket as Ferrini inbounds it to Jordan Jansen.
Yeah, Ben Denlinger checked in. He has the ball, gives it off to Jackson. Jackson comes up, hands out to Ferrini. Getting down low again to Jordan Jansen. Cutting down low to Jackson. Jackson pump fake goes up high. No good. Rebound by Denlinger. Denlinger goes up. Good. 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 Good.
Went up strong with the ball as Jackson wasn't able to get the floater to go.
Davis goes back up, misses, but gets his own rebound, puts it back up, and Davis is 27
of the night. He needs to figure out a way to slow him down. And their offense is running solely through him, and if he's scoring points like this, Coach Kaminsky's not going to be happy.
Vance Jansen drives nicely.
And see if we can slow down this offense. That is the Huskies. Now that Kitchen, he has 9 points after a couple quick threes.
Wildcats looking to butt into this 10-point lead as Vance Jansen takes the basketball. Top of the key. Looking to drive. Gives it to Ferrini. Ferrini backing out. Giving it to Vance Jansen. Jansen hands it off to Joseph. Joseph down low to Jack. Jack driving. Will spin with the basketball. Pounced on by a Husky. He loses that. And the Huskies will retain the basketball. And there will be another timeout on the floor. We will go to yet another quick break. We'll be right back with more Wildcats.
State.
So after a shot clock violation, it will be Husky basketball. And it looks like the Wildcats will come out in full court press as usual. Looks to be man-to-man. Inbounding the ball. It's Edie Anderson. Edie Anderson picks the ball. Court guarded by Barry. Going to the right side on the right wing. Looking down low to Davis. Gets the ball to Davis. Davis loses it. Almost saved by Jax, but it is tipped back in. Three-pointer on the way is no good. And that will be rebounded by Dentlinger. Dentlinger gets out to Van Jansen. Jansen drives. Pulls it back out to Jax. Slows him down. Sets up the offense. Gives it to Kendall Jax. Jax, nice little spin move from 10 feet out. Goes up and is fouled by number 22, Kitchen. And he will go to the line for a pair of free throws. Wildcats are 50% from the free throw line tonight. 2-for-4 out of that free throw. He's only going for Kendall Jax. His 7th point of the night.
And this thing needs to figure out a way to keep some free throw line. May only have 60% right now.
Checking in is the highly athletic Altavius Jackson in place of Nick Ferrini as the Wildcats maintain this full court press as Edie Anderson breaks free, kicks out to Kitchen, Kitchen 4-3, and that is good. Kitchen has caught fire, no pun intended, as he has 12 points. Joseph has the ball, gives it to Vance Jansen. Jansen drives, kicks it back out, gives it to Joseph. Joseph, oh, here's the
in offense, I think they have a nice 3-point shooting team and do a good job of getting to
the line. Edie Anderson gives it down low. As Davis goes up for another 2-point lead, making it look too easy for the Huskies as they maintain their 10-point lead.
And then when you're over pursuit on that nice pass out, you need to take one or two steps off the net and just play a little bit better because not one is quite so hard.
And that pass is picked off by Kitchen. Kitchen passes it to Davis. Davis goes up strong. His foul in the basket is good. Not a lot of contact over the Reds saw enough to call the foul, and that will send Davis to the free throw line in search of his 34th point.
Now, Wayne State, you know, this isn't a one-man wrecking crew in Davis. He's doing a nice job scoring. He's getting his own. However, Mason has 15, and Kitchen has a lot of runs. We're going to figure out a way to slow down this very athletic St. Cloud State team. 13 minutes left to play this play.
First free throw is on the way to Nick Burks. As Ferrarini checks in for Altavius Jackson. Ferrarini looking to get a couple more points on the board. Ferrarini with 7 on the night. 1 assist. He played all right, but looking to get a couple more shots up. As Vance Jansen gets across the timeline, coming off the screen by Jansen. Gets it back out to Jackson. Down low to Jordan Jansen. Jordan Jansen. This will be Marshall on the right wing. First time he's checked in here in this second half. Marshall driving on. Perrine kicks it back out to the corner. As Marshall gets the ball back, stuck in. Kicks it back out to Onyeka. Onyeka misses the lead. Vance Jansen gets the rebound as Joseph goes up strong. No good. Jordan Jansen puts it back up and it misses. So that will be rebounded by the Husky basketball. 11:51 remaining in the second half.
Now, Jordan didn't go up with two hands. He went up with one trying to get the tip in. I'm fine with the tip in. I think you got to go up with two hands. He just shorted that tip back.
Long three by Davis is missed, but rebounded by Onyeka. Onyeka gives it to Davis in the corner. Davis doubles him, gives it back out to Onyeka. Onyeka wide open three, pulls up, and that is good. Cannot get a good hand open on the three. Onyeka
gets something right there. He's got to keep his head up. As soon as that shot went in, he dropped his head. He's saying there's not much I can do, and I understand there's not much you can do, but you got to forget about
goes up, no good. Fighting for the rebound is Jordan Jansen, who doesn't get it. Rebounded by the Huskies, and the Huskies look to slow things down as they now feel a lot more comfortable with their 14-point lead.
And you see, they've got to figure out a way to chop this lead down. Maybe if you can get it down to about 8 points, about an 8-minute mark, get it down to 5 points and five. And they see it's kind of like where they're at.
Davis pulling up from anyone now, misses the long rebound by Perry. Perry Fields pushing the basketball. Gives back out to Joseph. Joseph and Jax. Jax down low to Jansen.
Jax thought about the three-pointer. Had a nice three-pointer. I don't think I'd have been mad about that shot. Finds Jordan Jansen underneath the basket for a much easier shot. As Perry takes a shot to the face. And they're going to call him for the fouls. I think Jax came over and got the help off of the play. So, no shot is no good off the Kendall Jax block. However, Farina picks up the ball. Well, that is just his first three-pointer in a row with 7 points, a rebound, and
so Marshall will head to the free throw line for his first free throw. Free throw's up and rattles out. So no good. It is the lanky 6'8" Sean Smith for the Huskies. And plays up Davis.
Looking left, the lot of guys all the way around the scene right now is Davis. I can't see anything. So he's going to at least take a little bit of a breather here. As Kyrie checks out, I believe they make him check out. Might have a little bit of blood on his muscles. I don't understand that. As he goes into the training.
Second free throw on the way for Marshall, and that is good. To extend the lead to 13 for the Huskies. Davis Jansen getting the ball and taking it up the court. Jansen driving middle. Loses the basketball. Gets it back, but there was a foul call. That will be against Vance Jansen. That will be his third foul of the ballgame. Fourth foul of the ballgame. So he is in a lot of foul trouble, and he will come out. In place will come Luke Terhart.
I'd like to see Wayne State turn the boundary right here. Just a little bit. Another two possession. See what the St. Cloud can do. Because Bonner's obviously quite a bit bigger body than any of the other Wayne State folks. See if he can manhandle. Very nice touch from the run ring. Give him the ball down. Two feet.
Marshall has the ball. Drives on the right side. Nice pass by Marshall. Two nice.
Chipped away at this lead, something they're very capable of, down by 19, or excuse me, 18 last week. The Wildcats just have to figure out a way to sure up their defense, and I think that's going to
fall. Jordan Jansen gets it to Jax. Jax down low back. Jordan Jansen. Bringing back to 15 as Marshall takes the ball to court. Guarded by Joseph. Hands it off to Okonkwo. Or excuse me. Davis. Down low. Davis goes up. And his 36th point of the night. Gerhard takes the ball before it gets it across the timeline. And gives it to Jordan Jansen. Hands it back off to Gerhard. Gerhard to Jackson. Jackson looking down low. Doesn't get it to him. Gives it back to Joseph. Joseph. Step back three is no good off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Davis.
Yeah, Kendall Jax needs to get this free throw. The Wildcats need to figure out a way to perform this ball. I like what they do. They definitely need to figure out a way to do it and do it now. With 1 minute left in this game.
Still time left, but the Wildcats need to act quickly as Jax free throw is up and it rattles home. And stay out to the full court press. As Davis breaks it, no problem. And there is a late foul call that will be on Kendall Jax, and that will send Davis to the free throw line yet again.
So Fisher saw a little bit too much contact. Coach Davis was upset with that foul. I think that's one ball.
Yeah, very tough call for the official as Davis knocks his first one down. And checking into the game for the Huskies is Diamond Omuka in place of Jace Kitchen. like you said, Gage Davis, 43 points on the night, 4 rebounds. As the second he throws up, and that is Magic number 44 for Davis. Moore, skip pass to Barry Mead, and gets past that board. Barry Mead gets it to Jax. Jax back out to Vance Jansen. Jansen, 4-3. Omuka pulls up 4-3, and that is number one shot by Perrine. Perrine off to the races, gives it out to Jax. Jax to Nate Moore. Nate Moore, 4-3. And that is no good. Rebounded by Kendall Jax. Kendall Jax goes up. And that's the back with 11. And we have a timeout. We'll take a 30-second break. We'll be right back with more basketball. Back here in Rice Auditorium, it is Wayne America as the Wayne State Wildcats are now just down 11 with 3 minutes and 10 seconds remaining to the Huskies. As the Huskies get the ball into Davis, Davis gives it back to Edie Anderson. Anderson having some trouble getting it across half court. Ball is tipped and it will be brought down by Tyson. Gives it back to Edie Anderson. Edie Anderson gives it to Kitchen. Kitchen hands it off to Edie Anderson. As it is clear the Huskies are trying to waste as much clock as possible. As Smith drives, dumps it down low, and that will be up and good for Davis. His 46 points of the night as Moore takes the ball across the timeline. Moore driving, stops, gives it back to Barry. Gives it to Jax. Jax, pump fake, pulls up 4-3, and that is off the front of the rim. No good rebound by Tyson as Edie Anderson really looks to slow things down, just barely crawling across that half-court line.
Yeah, Wayne State's got to figure out a way to put points on the board. That's what this is going to come down to. As Huskies turn the ball over, Davis is going to be able to get his feet set and ball into the bottom. And so 2.5, 2.14, 2.19, that's by 13. And I don't think so. He's got to figure out Ferry. Long three is tipped. Rebounded by the Huskies. 3-on-1 transition. Kitchen goes up and slams home. And that gets a goal from the visiting crowd. As the Huskies now take a commanding 15-point lead from the 2 minutes play. As Jax goes up, and that is a transition by Jax. As the Wildcats have put on full court pressure. Yet again, we are stolen by Farine. Farine looks at Nate Morph. Morph eats out to Vance Jansen. Jansen for 3. And that's